Hey, Dave here, and I would like to thank LBN for sponsoring this episode. LBN is an award-winning children's book author. You can find out information about her career at her website, lbn.com, and get books like this on Amazon. Perfect for the kids, even adults. Thank you, LB. Enjoy the show, and thank you so much for watching. Well, was a concert, then this would have been it. You see, I had gotten word from a very reliable source, Instagram, that Dave Koz was bringing his Summer Horns tour to Orlando, Florida in 2021, right in the middle of the pandemic. And I live in Orlando, so I thought, man, this would be a great, great opportunity to catch up with my friends on the road and to see a show that I had never seen before at a time where we all needed music. Because we were in the middle of the pandemic, there were a lot of venues and cities all around the world that did not allow public gatherings indoors. So the Dr. Phillips Center for Performing Arts in Orlando did this thing called Front Yard Festival, presented by Advent Health. And it's super cool because they took the front lawn of the Dr. Phillips Center and they put all of these pods, or some people call them cages, there on the lawn, so that small groups can gather outdoors in a little, you know, little cubby safe environment. And that's where the Summer Horns tour was coming. Now picture this, you're in beautiful Central Florida, but it is the summertime and it is Florida. So what happens every day pretty much during the summer? Torrential downpour. I'm not talking about pity pat, you know, sound of the rain against my window pane. I'm talking hide your wife, hide your kids, run for cover, duck and hide, get out type thunderstorms. Crazy. Well, that's exactly what happened. So we're talking the crew having to shut everything down, put up tents and tarps and cover all the equipment because it's getting soaking wet. Now you got electrocution issues. It's just a whole big hassle. It's a big thing. An insult to injury was not just the pouring rain soaking everything on the stage. It was the code red that we entered because lightning had struck near the venue. And every time that happens, there's an alarm that goes off and everybody, like, code red, everybody indoors, cameraman included.
The forecast shows like scattered thunderstorms till 4 o'clock.
And then it's going to be sunny again?
And then it goes to cloudy and then mostly cloudy.
And then they all get to go to the beach or Disney World?
So the question is, what do the musicians do while we're in code red? We rehearse, of course. This is what rehearsal looks like in the middle of a code red in Orlando, Florida, hours before the show.
Yeah, yeah.
way. So right around the third code red, Dave comes to the venue and I finally got to catch up with him.
What? What? My dressing room is private. I was just thinking about you. I was wondering where you were.
I've been here the whole time.
Oh, okay.
Been getting so much great footage, man.
Yeah, you mean the downpour? Torrential downpour on our outside?
I got it.
It went from like green and then they were like code red, everybody in the building. And then you go to code red, we call it. Wow. They got green, yellow, orange, red.
Boom.
And then so you have to wait 20 minutes after the last lightning strike.
Wow.
So then every time one hit, we have to go back. I'll come back in a little bit.
Thanks so much.
Me, I'm a keyboard player, so there's a lot of things that I don't understand about the saxophone world. So it was really, really cool to get an opportunity to go behind the scenes in their dressing room to see what happens in the preparation that takes place before the show.
This is all very, Khristian, all very, very important stuff. The cleaning of the mouthpieces.
Indeed.
After 2 days of playing, it's like, okay. Gotta get... Can
we
get some soup on there? But
I do need to just tell one quick story about cleaning of the mouthpieces.
Let's hear it.
So I got a chance to meet my mentor, the great Sonny Stitt, and got a lesson from him after a gig. I was 19. And we're in the hotel room, and he said, "Give him a horn out." You know, of course, he was, you know, loaded. God bless him. And so I got his horn out, and I opened that case, and I swear, I just bought past him. It was the worst smell I ever smelled in my life. I mean,
wow.
it was bad. I mean, just fried chicken and scotch, you know, for a month and a half, you know. And so I said, man, I gotta sneak over and clean this out. And so I went over to the sink, and I gently turned on the faucet, and I started running away. Hey, what the f*** you doing? I didn't tell you to do all that. Don't touch that. Because those old cats were very suspicious about, you know, if it plays right, don't touch it.
Right.
Don't touch a thing. Don't rinse it. Don't clean it. Don't wipe it.
So he never cleaned his mouthpiece?
I'm going to say never. I mean, you know, whatever.
Wow.
Sonny's good. You know, arguably one of the greatest saxophones ever. You know, germs were living in there that were, you know, good year and a half old.
So I shouldn't feel bad about
right. Exactly, man. You know,
you should feel good about that because that looks like you got a good read.
You know,
just keep hold of that.
It works.
It's never going to die. I know it. I'm just going to keep it from
there. There's enough living organisms. There are living organisms on there that are keeping it alive.
No, but when you get a good one, see, that's the thing. When you get a good read, it's like a gift from the gods. It's like, and you keep praying every day. When you put it on, you say, okay, please play again for me today.
Yeah.
But that's what's really nice about this tour, is that we are...
saxophone dorks.
You know, like you're on, it's like high school. You're in high school with the sax section every day. And it's really kind of nice, because they feel my pain, and I feel theirs.
You know, backstage, we get to be the nerds we truly are, as opposed to, oh yeah, that's the cool people with the saxophone.
That's true.
Yeah, that's
nerds.
True. All the way.
Figure out?
This one?
That's a
Stoddart.
Oh, that's a key that sticks because of the humidity.
My G-sharp just stuck. Yours too, right?
See, do you see how they understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
That happened to me last night because my C sharp was stuck.
Everything was sticking.
Break, actually.
You know, just the humidity, right?
Yeah, so let's do song, so we'll do the chorus and then the tag.
Did you notice, by the way, last night that in the first show it was an 8-bar guitar solo and nobody said anything, and then the second show was a 4-bar guitar solo and nobody said anything?
Someone's saying something now. It's supposed to be a 4-bar guitar solo, so let's see.
That was really funny, though. It was an 8-bar, but nobody said anything.
No one said anything. It was just like,
so tonight is 16,
and we'll see. That's because we go with each other.
See what we get.
We go with each other.
Yeah. Christian is going to be loud, so just giving you...
I'm ready.
Fair warning.
We ready.
So right after Randy's guitar solo, it's chorus, and then the tag out.
So finally, the code red is lifted, and the band gets to go back out on stage and actually begin an actual sound check. Four, Marcus Finnie on drums, Nate Kearney Jr. on bass, my good friend John Stoddart on keys, and the incomparable, the living legend, Randy Jacobs on guitar, who's the MD for the whole thing. Dudes were getting ready to destroy the place. It is a well-known, industry-understood, bona fide fact that Dave Koz is one of the best dudes on the planet. The most kind-hearted, gentle-spirited, incredibly benevolent, patient, just a great, great guy.
Maybe people suspect that Dave Koz is an altruistic and gracious and magnanimous person. They suspect that, they said this, but there's no way he could really be like that, like in real life. And I'm here to tell you, that is how he is. It's how he always is. It doesn't matter, sound check, on the van, in the van, on the plane, at the airport. He's just a gracious person. And he puts other people first. I think certain people, when they receive, accolades and favor, it makes sense because frankly, it's like they kind of put it out there, and so that's what they get back, and that's how Dave is.
So being able to be a personal friend of his is a very big honor for me, and to have him give me this access is something that I will never ever forget. And getting to shadow him, let me tell you, it's a treat.
Good. Just
Does everybody know Khristian?
We in the building. We in the building.
He's doing a different thing today. He's showing a different side of him.
Definitely.
On the singing side.
It's new. Yeah, you each get a cage. Like we have our cage.
I can't clap like this. Coffee! I need coffee!
This particular sound check was especially delicious because of a song that Kirk Whalum and the team rehearsed called Don't Get Me Wrong. Absolutely insane.
So okay.